Staring at herself in the mirror on the restroom door. Voices in her head that mirror what she's heard before.
Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today let us draw cycloidal curve. Here in today's class we will do half of the cycloid in the horizontal direction and remaining half cycloid in the vertical direction. First, we will see what is cycloid. Okay, here cycloid means, before explaining the definition, I will give one example. Here I am taking one circle. Let us assume this is our circle, and now this is the horizontal surface. Okay, now it is moving on the horizontal surface. Okay, let us assume like that. Here I am taking this circle is at this point. Take one of the point on the circle. Okay, this point is on the circumference of the circle. This is our P point. Okay, let us see if the circle is, this point is initially at this surface. Okay, point is at this surface. I am marking this point position on the surface. Okay, now let us see this P point is moving with the circle when the circle is rotating like this. Okay, now again this P point is touching the horizontal surface. Whatever position here, starting position, so same position it is coming here. If you mark the position here, okay, here roughly, so from this point to this point, circle is making one complete rotation. Okay, this is the starting point, this is the ending point. At both positions, this point is touching the surface. Okay, this surface is a horizontal surface. Okay, tracing the path means, if you are marking this P position whenever this circle is rotating, so let us assume I have already marked this P position here. Now circle is rotating like this. Okay, mark this P point here on the paper. We are tracing the path of the P. Okay, so mark this point here. Approximately I am doing. So here also mark the P position. Okay, now similarly it is coming here. Okay, now if we join all this P position, okay, if we trace this P point, we are getting, if you join this, okay, so this path of this V point is called cycloid. For complete length it is moving one revolution. So how much this length? This length is nothing but the circumference of this circle. Okay, so in one complete rotation it is moving 2 pi r length. Okay, we have one formula for calculating this length, horizontal length. Okay, so we need to substitute radius of this circle in it. Take the next case. Here we have to do the half cycloid in the horizontal direction, half cycloid in the vertical direction. Okay, so circle is making half of the distance moving horizontally, half of the distance vertically. Let us assume this circle is moving horizontally half of the rotation and the remaining half on the vertical. Let us take, this is the P point. I am marking P point here. Okay, now this circle is moving like this. Mark the position of the P point. Now it is coming here. So initially the circle is here like this. The P point is here. Now P point is opposite to it here. Okay, so we are getting the path of P is like this. Okay, so for half cycloid we are getting like this. Okay, now this again it is moving like this circle, remaining half. Okay, so here if we trace this P point, so this P point will come like this. Okay, so for the horizontal it is making this one, for the vertical it is moving like this. Let us do this path, half of the cycloid in horizontal, remaining half in the vertical. Let's first take the given question. A circle of diameter 50 mm, the diameter is 5 cm, rolls on a horizontal line for a half revolution. Okay, so it is making half revolution horizontally and then on a vertical line upward for another half revolution. Another half revolution it is making vertically. Draw the curve traced out by a point lying on the circumference of the circle. So this curve is called, as I told, cycloid. Okay, half cycloid is coming horizontally, remaining in the vertical. So our diagram will come like this. Okay, for the circle, so by using instruments first we will do this circle. This circle diameter is given, it is 5 cm. What is the radius? It is 2.5 cm. For complete one revolution or one rotation it is moving L length, that is circumference of the circle. Okay, for the half revolution, so half revolution means in total 2 pi r by 2. Okay, So it is pi r. First we will calculate this length by using the calcium. 2 pi r by 2 means it is pi r. Okay, so pi, take in centimeters, so that we are drawing in centimeters. This value is 7.85 centimeters, and this is also pi r, same length, 7.85 centimeters. 7.85 centimeter, it is moving horizontally, and remaining half, 2 pi r by 2, that is 7.85 centimeter, it is moving vertically. Let us do this diagram by using the instruments. First take the center of the circle. From center take the radius 2.5 centimeter. Okay, by using compass, I am taking 2.5 centimeter and as center C point. Okay, do the circle with 2.5 centimeter radius. I did horizontal diameter, vertical diameter. After that, so here from this point to center line, distance is pi r. Okay, so it is 7.85. Do the horizontal surface of length 7.85 centimeters. So here take this diameter is the reference. Just do one line here of some length. Okay, it is a horizontal surface. On it mark 7.85. 7.85. So this is the horizontal surface. After that, after doing this surface, just do the center line also of the same length. So center line means which is passing through center. Take this line is a reference. I'm using the roller scale for doing the parallel lines. So just do at the center also 7.85. Okay, and then after that, this is another center. Do this circle here also. Take this point as center. So after doing this, so from this center to another center, the distance is 7.85. So at the center, do one vertical line of some length. Okay, so on it mark 7.85. So this is the center line. Okay, and do the vertical surface also. So take the same length. Just tilt the scale here. So this is the vertical surface. Okay, here also do the circle. Okay, this point is the center. Now this point is the center. Do one more circle here. After that, so join this horizontal surface and the vertical surface like this. Extend this vertical surface like this. Okay, we did the position of the circle. Okay, during rotation, half rotation, the circle will come, remaining half circle will come here. Divide this circle into 12 divisions. As we know, at the center the angle is 360 degrees. We have to divide into 12 parts that angle. Okay, each part is 30 degrees. Okay, by using the protractor, I am taking 30 degrees here. Okay, for dividing the circle. So take this diameter is a reference, 30 degrees, again 30 means it is coming 60, again 30 means 90, again 30, 90 plus 30 means 120, 120 plus 30 means 150. Okay, join these points to the center for getting the equal divisions. Here I will join this point to center within the circle. Okay, and extend line this side also, because circle is symmetrical about this diameter. Okay, now next point to center. No, already we did vertical line here. Take this point. Now take this point. Now after dividing circle, give the names of these points. I am taking this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we are taking this point is initial point also, 12th point. We are considering it is P point also. P comma 12, both are at the same point. After marking P point, for tracing the P point, here we have to divide this center to center distance into 6 equal divisions. Okay, for marking center 1, center 2, center 3 like that. Okay, for dividing this length into 6 parts, first we will divide this distance into 6 parts. Just drop this line here. Okay, this point to this point I am making into 6 divisions. Okay, so how to divide into 6 divisions of any line? So for it, we are following one process. Just do one line or inclined line here. Okay, inclined line of some angle. Okay, this angle should be less. By using compass, take any radius, small radius. So here divide it into 6 divisions. Okay, first part, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Join this point, last point, to this point. Okay, this last point with the help of scale. So after getting this inclined line, at all these points do the lines which are parallel to this one. Okay, for getting parallel lines I am using roller scale. It is easy to do the parallel lines. Keep on this side is coincide with the scale. Just shift the scale in upward, do the line here and here also. So do the intersection points of these points. Okay, here I am giving it is 1 dash, this intersection point is 2 dash, this intersection point is 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, and then six, this is 6 dash. After getting these points, at all these points, do the vertical lines up to this center line. Okay, take this diameter is the reference diameter. Shift the scale at 1 dash, do the vertical line up to the center line. Okay, and here also. Already at 6 with the line. Here mark the intersection point. 1 dash is C1. So 2 dash line up to center is C2 intersection point. This is C3, C4, C5, and then this is C6. Here we are making center C1, C2, C3 up to C6. Why means this circle is rotating like this. Okay. So center is changing. So initially it is C, now it is coming C1, now it is coming C2 like that, C3. That's why we are dividing this into 6 parts. So 6 centers we have marked here. Here after dividing the center line into 6 divisions, so here also divide into 6 divisions. Okay, because circle is moving like this. Okay, so centers are also changing. So already we did here center distances. So take the same distance, any distance, mark C7, C8, C9 up to C12. Okay, take the center distance. So from C6 by using compass, take this is a C7, C8, C9, C10, C11, and this is a C12. Mark the intersection points as C7, C8, C9, C10, C11, and this is C12. Here whatever divisions we are doing, 6 divisions, here also we are making 6 divisions. Okay, after that, here whatever points are there, okay, just do the horizontal lines at all the points, do the, up to this circle. So take this line as a reference line, okay, and here by using roller scale, at one do the horizontal line, okay, at one point. 1 and 11 are passing through the same line. Like this. Extend the line this side also. And similarly at 2 and 10, both are coming on the same line. And then next 9, 3 already we did line, both are coming on the center line. Okay. Next is 8, 4. And then next 7, 5. And then at 6, extend this line like this. Extend this one also. So after getting these lines, so here the intersection points, okay, these points are dividing this circle also 12 equal divisions. So here we have divided into 12 divisions. Mark the points. For marking the points, initially the P point is here, okay, 1 is coming here, okay, P1 here, 2 here, like that. Now it is making half revolution like this. So it is coming, P point is coming here, so 1 is coming here this side. Okay, 1, 2, 3 like that. So mark this point is 1. So this point is 1. So already 1, 2, 3 we are marking here. So 1, 1, small 1. This point is 2, 1. Inside I am marking. This point is 3, 1. Just difference I am taking points. Instead of 1, I am taking 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, these points. And this is 4, 1. And this is 5, 1. And this is 6, 1. 7, 1. 8, 1. This is 9, 1. Okay, this is 10, 1. This is 11, 1. This is 12, 1. Okay, inside the circle I am marking. So just the position of the points are changing here. Okay, now after that, here at all these points, do the vertical lines so that we can divide the circle also into 12 divisions. Here, do the vertical lines. So use the roller scale for getting the parallel lines. So I will start from here. Already we did one line here. Here at 10, 8, I am doing one line. Both are moving on the same line. Both points are on the same line. And 11, 7 on the same line. And then, so 6, 12 and center are on the same line. And then 1 and 5 on the same line. And then 4 and 2 are on the same line. And then at this 3, it is coming here. Okay. Now here also we have divided into 12 divisions. In this stage, we did the positions of the circle. We have divided the entire 3 circles into 12 divisions. After that, we have divided the center line 6 parts. Here also vertical side 6 parts. Okay, after that, we will trace the path of the P point. Okay, as we know, from center to P position, it is constant while rotating. Okay, this distance is radius. That's why take the radius of the circle. Take C1 center. Okay, do an arc on the first line, which is passing through 1. Okay, now C2 center. Do an arc on the second line. And C3 as center, do the line on the third line. This is the third line which is passing through this. And C4 center, do an arc on the fourth line which is passing through 4. C5 center, do on the fifth line which is passing through fifth one. And C6 center, do on the sixth line which is passing through 6. So I am giving these intersection points. The intersection point of first line and this arc is, I am taking, this is P1. P1. And the second arc, second line is P2. And here one arc and third point P3, and this is P4, and this is P5. Here we got one point P6 also. Okay, so the curve will come. If you join all the P points, it is coming like this. Okay, after that C7, after C6, C7 center, do an arc on the seventh line which is passing through 7. This point is, the intersection point is P7. Next, C8 center, do an arc on the 8th line. So this is it, 8th line. So this is P8. Okay. Now C9 center, do an arc on the 9th line. Okay, this is the 9th line, which is passing through 9. This is P9. Take the center C10, do an arc on the 10th line, which is passing through 10. Just do here. It is coming here, this side. Okay, so P10. Similarly, take C11 center, do an arc on the 11th line which is passing through 11. So I am marking P11. Now take C12 center, do an arc on the 12th line. This is the 12th line. Okay, so this is P12. This point is, it is coinciding with circle also. Okay, if you join all the P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11, P12, we will get the cycloid. Let us do the cycloid with freehand curve. First, I will join from P to P1, P1 to P2, P2 to P3, and then P3 to P4. P4 to P5, P5 to P6, so So we have joined all these points from P to P6. After that, P6 to P7 here. Okay. Join P6 to P7 and then P8 here. Just join like this. And P8 to P9. Okay. So this point is coming here. It is like this curve. So this is P9. Now P9 to P10. Now P10 is little difference from P8. Okay. So try to join P9 to P10, P10. And then P10 to P11. And then P12. Okay. Make it dark. So here P8 and P10 has very little difference. So try to join through P9, these two points. So this is the entire curve. The P path is moving. Okay. While the circle is rotating horizontal half revolution and then next half revolution vertically. Here the given circle and the path and the given surface, that is horizontal and vertical, should be in dark colors, and mark the given dimension. Take any one diameter, mark 50 mm here, and the horizontal path distance is 78.5 mm. And vertical distance path is also 78.5 mm. This is a cycloidal curve when the circle is moving horizontally as well as vertically. The other video links I will give in description box. Please check it. That is cycloidal curve, epicycloid, hypocycloid. If you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.